The crew went to go do an event for Beauty Couture today, and of course I wasn't there, unfortunately, so I can only imagine how that conversation is going. Oh, Amber isn't here again. The story of my life. My daughter had a car accident, so I couldn't be there, and today was just so emotional for both of us. She called me, and that's the worst thing you can hear, or a mother can hear on the other end of the phone, is that, "Mom, I've been in a car accident." But she's okay, and I'm glad about that. Okay, guys, so now we are going to transition into a night lift that can easily be worn for day, so don't be scared by the tone of the lip. And you notice that I don't wear lip liner. I rarely ever use a lip liner. That's just my preference, but if you want to, you definitely can do a lip liner with this. If you do choose to do a lip liner, make sure you try to go at least the same tone. Because it's already a dark lip, you don't need to go with a darker liner. Okay guys, so we are wrapping up Makeup With Me Monday. I am so glad you guys came and tuned in with me. I know you guys have so many questions. Everybody wants to do a highlight and contour look. This ain't the time for that, boo. This was a natural look. Oh my God. Okay guys, I gotta go. It's my girl Ty Call calling me, and meet me back here with Makeup With Me Monday next Monday. See you there. Bye. What's up, girl? Girl, in here chilling with Scooby. Come here, Scooby. So I texted her earlier and told her that I wasn't going to be at Beauty Couture today. So she's going to stop past the house tonight just to check on Amani and see how she's doing.
Okay, so I just wanted to go to Amber's house just to see what was up. Like, this is the second thing Amber has missed.
I'm in the hotel. Can you hear me?
And you know, I just want to know what's up. What's up with my friend that I put you in this group and I wanted you to be a part of it, and you're never there? Seems like to me, that's why some of what he's saying is true. I hope not. But it's looking like it. You're never there.
Makeup artist means to me someone who finds the beauty in things that are already there and enhancing it. Not changing, not altering, not filtering, but finding that beauty and enhancing, whether it's in their eyes, whether it's their lips, whether it's their cheekbones, whether it's their skin structure, whatever it is, find that beauty in that, in each and every client that you have, and enhancing that. Now, as far as what I feel makeup artists or the new makeup artists, what they're missing is individuality. I feel like I can walk into any makeup store or go to any show or any photo shoot and see the same look. I already see a lot of the same products being used. I already see a lot of the same techniques. I don't wear, even with the cast, we all are different. You can say, oh, I know Ty did that. Oh, I know Stefan did that. Oh, I know Shonda did that. Oh, I know whoever, you know, whoever. Even other artists that I've worked with from the past, you can say, oh, I know that. Oh, I know Sam Fine's makeup. Oh, I know Reggie Wells makeup. Now, these new artists, I feel like they're all doing the same thing. They all have this, you know, thick brow or bow lip or heavy, heavy highlight or heavy, heavy contour. And it's like, it's all the same. Find what it is that you like to do, what you like to enhance, and find your way to put your niche in that area. So that's what I would say new makeup artists missing. It's just their own individuality.
And I know that you said this was coming, but
Amani got into a car accident.
Are you serious? Because you know I was just in a freaking car accident.
Dead serious.
How's she feeling? Like,
I think she's probably like a little shook up, like still kind of like in shock. And knowing that I'm upset because it was in my car.
And you, so, mama.
And
it's like,
mama. Yeah.
You mom. It's like you mom and your friend, but your mama. And it's in your car.
When she, first of all, when she called me, she was like, you gonna be so upset with me. You gonna be so upset. So I was just like,
thinking something else.
Something else. Then she was, when she said she got an accident, girl, all I was like, it was almost like my baby, like, send me a picture. Send me a picture.
When
I saw the picture, girl, tears were just like,
are you serious? Today, I know. You know, her daughter was in a car accident, so she didn't make it to DC Beauty Couture. So, you know what? I feel kind of bad because I was kind of like, oh, she can't make it to something else. But that's my girl, that's my niece, and I know how she is about her daughter. So, I'm glad I could be there for her because I know she was a little shaken up.
But then, so I was really upset, like, really upset.
But then you thought, like, okay.
To my mom, she was like, well, it could have been worse. She could have run a pole.
She could have been dead.
It could have been all the way to the left.
I
was like, that's the right balance, you know what I mean?
Yeah, because it's kind of like, not that you like, my baby is okay.
Right.
So, because you talk to her, it's like, okay, send me a picture of my car.
Yeah.
That would be the first emotion for anybody, because it's not like, oh, I don't care if you're okay.
Because you're talking fine.
You're talking to me like, mom, da-da-da. So, that instant of mother's like, send me a freaking picture of my other baby.
Yeah.
So that I know how much I got to beat your tail, even though I can't beat you.
$2,500.
You got an estimate on that? You know, I haven't even got an estimate.
First of all, I took off work. When she called, out within an hour, I took off.
And went and got an estimate.
Yes.
He is taking me out of here.
He's the baby.
He's so daggone cute. So you, because I was like, dang, how'd she get an estimate? I haven't gotten an estimate at all, because you know I'm in therapy. So I have to go with my lawyer. He was at fault. He tried to curse me out. I didn't have an anxiety attack.
Did you have any witnesses?
Here I go.
Yes.
I'm sorry.
I'm not laughing.
You better just wait. Cause after I start breathing, right? I'm coming to full lodge and I'm gonna go all for you.
What? So did you have any witnesses though?
No.
Okay.
So I'm about to say the dog. The police officer, Scooby, and take me out of
there.
He's like, Ryan wasn't that accident. The police officer, when he got there, I was like she was in shock. And it's just, first of all, it happened so fast, but he was already in the wrong. I was coming this way, and you know how if you're this way and you're trying to turn in front of the car? You're okay, the car, you're supposed to wait until all the cars.
Exactly.
He tried to turn fast, tried to beat me, and I hit him. So he was in the wrong period, but he's cursed me out like I'm in the wrong. But that's all. So he was like, you're in the wrong. So, but she's probably, it messes you up because you could have been gone. Even though you're fine, even me being in an accident, they'll be like, you know, when you're fine, it's not. And even if I'm like my back and my neck and stuff,
people, when you're up and walking and you're like, I'm here, yeah. I'm alive, we're thankful for that. But that mentally, knowing that in a flick of a, like, just like that, you could have been gone.
Yeah.
It messes you up.
I know how she feels. I was just in a car accident the day after Christmas. So when you feel like your life could be gone and it's flash right before your eyes, I get it. So I wanted to make sure my niece was all right. All right, Amber, you're off the hook this time.
Did she go to the doctor?
Yeah, we went to the emergency room today. I gave her a prescription for her
Motrin.
For her
So I'm actually glad Ty came over. We talked about so much, had a few laughs, and she even made her a new boyfriend, Scooby, honey. He was all over her. But I am tired and I'm ready to go. And anybody who knows Ty, baby, that girl can talk. So I am wrapped all the way up for the night, honey. Good night.
All right. I'm getting out of here. You and Scooby. Scooby.
Scooby.
Tell Ty back. Wait, not the whole sexy joint. Girl, we get the whole look back. I'm getting out of here.
Today, I'm about to go into the store, talk to this young lady that I was referred to about putting my stuff in the store. So I'm about to go in, meet with her. She sounds really cool on the phone. So I think this is going to be an awesome opportunity for Blade of On to really, you know, branch out. And I don't have to just stay in one little area. I'm excited about this. It's going to be so awesome. Like, I'm about to blow up. Mama, I made it. Mama.
Hey, girl.
So let's talk business about me coming into the store. What exactly you expect from me? How soon you want to move forward? What you want, you know, from the company to come into the store? Just want to, because everything, I feel like everything is going to match in here. I'm excited.
Of course, I want the painted leather jacket.
Okay.
I want the distressed denim and the doors, of course.
Okay, so. That's perfect. So we can move. How fast you want to move?
Okay. As quickly as possible.
I can have it. March 18th will be perfect because I actually already have the material at home.
Okay,
great. I'll send some emails.
So we can do an actual like big debut.
Yes,
so
we can do a selection. Yeah, and then have everybody make sure that you know about the store and then know what's going on into the store. I'm thinking like red carpet. I'm thinking cameras. I'm thinking champagne. Okay. I'm so excited. I mean, it matches everything in the store, yeah. So it's like perfect because you're giving. Child, I'm about to walk this red carpet. I'm giving. I'm about to be on the beach. So this is
I'm excited.
Yes. So, but I'm so excited. So me and Ty told Ty to come up here because I need that like support. You know, she my mother for real.
Hey, hey girl. Listen, first of all, my hair god is coming down that little. Do I got a twin or something?
Hey,
I
got Ty.
About moving forward and putting Blade of On into the store. Right. The store.
Okay, so this matches your fly.
I know.
Like this would be so freaking dope.
This is gonna be
like it has cute. Everything in here, like denim, but then you can
you go out
to the club, you go on a date.
Yep. So I was like, yes, everything matches with Blade of On.
Right.
So this is gonna be awesome. I'm so excited, girl. I can't wait.
Look, where the hell has this been though? Are you serious? Yeah. This is the full-fledged law. That's my little thing. Full law. I love it. Okay, so when is are you gonna have like a launch or something?
I was just discussing that with Tim. So March 18th. Okay, and I'm trying to do like we're gonna do a big event. We wanna make sure we have the red carpet out. I wanna make sure it's like done real big because you know, who would have thought that Blade of On would be into my store.
I'm excited. I'm just thinking like, I mean, everything. I mean, from when you started Blair Devon.
Yeah.
Like, it's, I mean, it's only been like with me, maybe what, like a year or two or something
Not even that long. And it's just really, really, really been moving forward.
I told you, like,
yeah,
you stay focused. Stay focused. Even though sometimes it's hard to stay focused,
yeah.
But like, the meaning behind.
Yeah.
Like, that's really what, yeah. Doing. You know what I mean? That's why I say everything I do, even with the snob thing, it has a meaning behind it. So anybody else is doing something, the meaning is always going to
be
more
important.
It's always
going to be more important.
Good, because you could do distress, but okay, what's your meaning
behind
it?
What's your meaning, like, even now, talking about it and telling people about it, they're always like, well, what's your story?
Right.
And so the story is so amazing. The story is so amazing. So that's why it really makes it's a lot different from everybody else. And I'm not threatening, or I don't care about what you're doing and what you just did at your house in the washing machine in your bathroom. Girl, I don't care. Like, from my understanding, people been distracted before me. But it's they have probably.
Listen, I used to distract and bleach when I was 14.
Yeah, so it's like, but it's okay.
I used to make all the Marlin Troopers. Thank God I'm blessed with TGID. Yeah. I used to make all the IGs, cut them up, and all
and
of
cut
that.
Cut them up.
Again, it's the creativity and the meaning behind it.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're gonna have a launch party.
We'll do a launch party.
Okay.
Real big. Like the biggest.
Okay, are you gonna invite the whole crew?
Like who?
Okay, so what a makeup artist means to me is actually knowing your craft. I mean, I'm not hating on any of the new artists that's coming up, because guess what? I was a new artist. I just think that a lot of times it's a little too early to put makeup artist as your title. I mean, get to know your craft, do a little bit more work, and then say you're a makeup artist. You know, like when I started out, I didn't run around saying I'm a makeup artist. No, I said, listen, I'm just learning. And then after I learned and did a couple of different things and built up my resume, that's when I said I was a makeup artist. So I just think that everybody these days are a makeup artist. And it's so easy for them to say that. They don't do that with hairdressers, because they know they have to get that certificate. And they're not so easy to say, because they'll burn somebody's hair out. So that's what I think is missing from today's makeup artists. And y'all always use filters and Photoshop. Stop filtering out people's daggone moles and pores. Stop it.
Like the biggest.
Okay, are you gonna invite the whole crew?
Like who?
Sean, the thing called Tig, the beauty thing.
Step on the air right now.
Okay, this is what I think that it'll be a perfect. This is what I think. I think when you're doing big things, you'll see who supports you.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So I'm just thinking that maybe you invite the whole crew, or maybe I'll do it.
It's okay, but. What's the last one?
You don't have to. I'll invite everybody. I'll say, listen, we need to support, you know, and see who come. And then we leave it at that. I just think, like, get it out the way.
Right.
That way, if Picasso come, no, that's my bro. If he come, then, you know, you might not say anything to an event. But, you know, that might open up a door, you know, for
a door to get kicked out, or
what? I think, baby, well, you know, I do think that you should call him and be like, yeah, I need to talk to you.
No.
Shonda, listen. All right. You gotta do something, God.
I'm not gonna call, but you invite, and I'll just be like, all right, hey.
Right.
I either thank you for coming to support.
I think it'll be a good thing.
I don't want nobody fighting, like, you know, crazy.
Where's the owner? Where did she go?
Yeah,
I got to go.
She had
a
phone call.
Oh, my God. Yes, I was like, that's my chat. So I know, but I need to go.
Okay.
Well, so,
I just wanted to let you know, Tiana, that I bought you something.
What the heck? Where's my bag? I've been asking for the bag forever. God.
No, but I had to bring her something. We're going through it. You always, like, you got to be hands on.
Listen, congratulations on your jacket.
Thank you so much. Y'all bitches love them. That's right.
Today, I'm headed to meet my brother Enrique, fellow MUA, and we got really, really close back when we used to work at Tom Ford. Our schedules have been so busy and we haven't gotten to meet up, so today is just us talking and chatting before he heads to Rome.
Now, you know, how you doing? Where have you been?
Because you know you be having heart attacks, knowing what you be gone too soon.
No.
Like grandma always said, well, don't see you no more.
Don't want to be packing up.
Like, lady, stop acting like you trying to die all the time. Chad, first of all, walking from that parking lot. But what's up with you? I'm glad we got to get together.
I know, we both busybodies.
Oh. Sir. You the busybody because the body is becoming a lawn.
Sure, thank you.
Yeah, dog. Thank oh my you. God, where are all these muscles coming from? You getting ready for Rome. That's what that is.
Yeah, I'm going to be on these beaches with my sunscreen on. But I'm going to be on these beaches in Speedo. So I need to look good. Need to
wait
get
a
it right, get it
you
tight.
You need them little pants, them little drawers. With the law? With the. Mm-hmm. Oh God, they get pregnant.
Well, when in Rome. But for real, I'm so excited though. So excited. I'm gonna be able to see the Sistine Chapel ceiling in person, and that for me is like on my bucket list. Right.
Because
so
you have all these tattoos that are art anyway.
Yeah, this is a statue of David and Moses by Michelangelo. So yeah, I'm really
you better bring a Bible
really
and get all the scriptures.
There's Bible, some holy water.
Wait, and
you can
your
give
chest.
It to me. You can give it to me.
Oh, let me stop doing it. You know I always try to have church outside. And then you got your chest piece.
Yep. I actually might get it touched up before I go.
Boy, bye. Please sit down.
So what have you been up to, Miss Thang?
Okay, so you know,
not seeing me.
No, I know. That's why I was like, okay, I got to see my brother because I got to catch you up with all the stuff that's going on and talk to you about something. But I was like, we haven't even gotten to like hang out or anything. Then you got me out here with the sun, baby, on my back.
Yeah, we're going to be a little bit darker by the time we're done.
I can't. Well, what I got going on, I tried to start this whole beauty thing. You know, you already know how it is in the industry. And not to say that I'm getting tired of it. It's just so oversaturated with everybody's a makeup artist.
Yep.
But they don't do that. The thing about it is they don't do that when it's a hairstyle. Do you ever notice that certain occupations, people don't step out there and set? Because you burn somebody's hair out and they be bald.
Yeah.
But if you set them up on their face, they'd be like, I hope they like it. And some people,
and you know, they took away licensing a long time ago, so I feel like that had something to do with
do
it,
with
too.
That. So it's like, everybody is a makeup artist, and then everybody filters.
Yeah,
so
that gets on my nerves.
I think being in the game for so long, I think a lot of times we kind of, not that we get out of it, we still gonna be faces and stuff like that. I just think that I wanted to be behind the scenes, and if somebody comes to the DMV,
I pay my dues,
you know what I mean? So, all of this stuff, I'm like, all right, well, I'm going to bring some people I know together, you know, to come on a team. But half of these people don't show up. There's one person that is always on time.
And has a good job.
And
that normally equates?
Well.
Kind of.
I don't know.
Oh, Lord.
No, he's just always on time. That's why. Esquire is always on time. If I say be here, he's, you know, I don't ever be on time. You know, that's bad. I'm the boss. But he is always like 30 minutes early.
That's good.
Always the first one at the gig.
That's good.
But he is also the one that is rubbing the crew the wrong way.
So coming early makes him feel entitled?
I think so. But it's kind of...
You gotta show up.
You gotta show up, and it's kind of disrespectful to me.
Yeah.
I feel like, oh, okay, well...
Especially if you plan something and you have the date and the time.
And no shade, like, I'm busy at full launch.
If you make time, everybody should be able to make time.
Not to shade anybody.
Because you haven't made time for me.
I know, I'm sorry. And then bringing you here today, there was a reason because you know how I am. Like, I'm a ride or die and I'm loyal. And, like, if somebody don't rock with you, you already know how I am. I've been like, oh, I don't rock with you. Period. So when I was looking for the other person, I'm like, I really need somebody else, you know, to like be on the team. So when Holly was like, why don't you have Stefan? I was like, no, like, I don't like him.
No,
like,
old news.
I was like, I don't. I was like, you already know. I was like, and the thing about it is that he was like, really? I was like, well, you know, we've never even talked. I said, I think it's just based on me being friends, me, my brother, we're friends, and that's my brother, and I'm always like that with all of my friends. So I didn't get a chance to get to know him, and he was like, well, you know, he'll be good. So I did add him to the crew, you know. So I just wanted to let you know because I was like, all right, I gotta let you know, because I know you all about, like, sis, that's business.
Exactly. Business is business. You know, me, I'm all about my coin.
Exactly. And listen, at least I said something, because I actually told him. I was like, well, I'm just gonna let you know, because I didn't want to be faking phone. Mm-hmm. You know how people be like, I literally couldn't sit there.
Yeah.
And be around somebody, even though I didn't know the story or nothing. It was just like, oh, my, like, if y'all don't mix, then I don't mix with you. So I had to be honest and say, you know what? I can't sit here with you and look at you and not
without
be honest
addressing it
in your face. I did not like you.
I mean, the thing with me, the history we have, like, I don't, I have let that go. I have so many great things going on for me in my life. Like, I could see him and say hello.
And
friends,
then just,
no,
exactly.
But, you know, I could be cordial.
It's right.
Like, it's so old. So old. Like, I'm coming up on my 30th birthday. I'm like, letting go of all of that.
Hold up, Enrique. Mm-hmm. You coming in with that? Well, you know, Chill. I look like I'm 20 or something, but you know, I've been in my 30s for about 8 years. Dang, 30?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I'm trying
to go into 30 looking my absolute best.
You got to. That's why I tell these people, you know, this whole skincare and everything, and you know, everybody doesn't know, but you already know. You was the first person I told that I'm coming out with my skincare line.
Oh!
I'm coming out. Because remember, you was like, remember I had that stupid name?
Uh-huh.
Something like, what was that dumb name? And you laughed at me.
I was like, maybe you should.
You was like, keep looking.
Keep looking.
So tonight I've been asked to host a bowling party. Of course, Miss Alonja of the DMV. Besides being a makeup artist, I'm a DMV socialite radio host. So I'm really excited because I'm not moving away from being a makeup artist, but my heart and love is in media, radio, and hosting. So I can't wait to get to this bowling party and turn up. I sound crazy saying those words because I never say those words that everybody else say. I can't wait to large at the bowling party tonight. And hopefully my peeps will come through. Stephon came to support me, and you know what? It feels really good. We started off rocky, but Stephon is actually turning out to be a cool friend. So I'm glad he's here. And besides that, he know everybody at the daggone food bar and the daggone bowl now.
You got some holy juice back there?
She don't drink.
Some wealth to drink. They used to laugh at me about my Amaretto sour. They said that's a 1992.
Looks, I see Ty, but I don't see nobody else. It was like it's just us. It's just us.
When I say the only people here is me and dang on crickets.
There is no one in here but me, Ty, and the people who work here.
What the hell did you invite me to?
And
so whose event is this?
Job. I'm being paid for it, and I'm, you know, I always try to be professional. But dang, who you sell the tickets to? The ghost? Because they show is ghost up in here.
To the bar! I need a drink, because I feel like this is about to be a long bowling party with just us.
And you know we in hood.
Yeah, well, but see, I live in Calabasas. You know Calabasas is only two exits out.
That's different. We
exactly.
Here.
Two exits down.
This is three to down. That's like I'm
doing it.
By East and two
Issue. Three to down. see the agencies in the building. Let's get it.
Nobody pray for me. If it not there for me. Yeah, yeah.
Bam. But y'all know, like I said, I'm here every Thursday. Of course I'm gonna get a strike. I got like four in a row right now, something like that. I don't know. Of course, I'm almost proud.
Hey, hey, y'all better stop playing with me. Didn't y'all see me? Well, I did get a gutter ball that time. But I'm gonna get a strike. I'm not as good as they gonna step on over here hitting every dag on pin. Listen now, I don't do that. Got a strike. Take that, Mr. Bowling League, Stephon, MUA model, icon, legendary. I'm getting a whole bunch of strikes. And now that Harley and the crew is here, I'm doing better than him.
On the next Real Makeup Artists of DC.
Like, I come in, they're late. The only person here is Esquire.
Are you serious? Y'all quick to tell me, I'm supposed to tell you how I feel to you.
He has no personality.
So that's why I walked out and I was like, I can't stand him. Let me leave before I smack him.
If I offended you, be a man about it. Don't have to hide your body go.
And if it's the issue, it's just gotta be said. Like, what are our charges?